messengers, Muhammad ibn Abdullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, upon his family, his companions, and all who follow him in righteousness until the day of judgment. Indeed, my beloved brothers and sisters, we are now commencing our journey, inshallah ta'ala. And this journey is a journey to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is a journey to Allah, inshallah, trying to develop a relationship, a love, a closeness with Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, our creator. And we know that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he said, respond to that which will give you life. And we know that the Quran and the Sunnah is what gives true life to the believer. Without the Quran and the Sunnah, there is no hayat. There is no life. There is no sweetness, inshallah ta'ala. There is no real taste of iman. So inshallah, utilize the next 5 to 6 hours, inshallah ta'ala, engaging in the talbiyah. Labbaik Allahumma labbaik, labbaik la sharika laka labbaik, inna alhamda wa ni'mata laka wal mulk la sharika lak. You'll take a nap every now and then. We have a long ride, 5-6 hours before we get there, inshallah ta'ala, with the stops that we're going to make. When you wake up from your little naps, again, make talbiyah, read Quran, inshallah ta'ala, make dhikr. We know that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he told us about dhikr, al-du'a huwa al-ibadah. That du'a is the core, it is worship itself, inshallah ta'ala, and it is what is beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So inshallah ta'ala, my beloved brothers and sisters, that this trip that we are upon, inshallah ta'ala, it is part of following the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we know that if we want to gain the love of Allah jalla wa ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has told us in his glorious and noble book, قُلْ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُحِبُّونَ اللَّهِ فَاتَّبِعُونِي يُحْبِبُكُمُ اللَّهُ وَيَغْفِرْ لَكُمْ ذُنُوبَكُمْ. Say to them, O Muhammad, if you truly love Allah, then follow me. Follow Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in everything, and Allah will love you. And not only will Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala love you, but he will forgive you your sins, inshallah ta'ala. So this is the purpose of this trip, my beloved brothers and sisters, that we want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to love us. We want Allah jalla wa ala to have mercy upon us. We want Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to pardon us, to forgive us for our many shortcomings, for our sins, because we are humans. And we know that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that all of the sons of Adam are sinners, and the best of them are those who recognize that they are sinners and they repent to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So my beloved brothers and sisters, inshallah ta'ala, remember the journey that you are on. The Sahaba radhiyallahu alayhim and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it would take them weeks to take this journey on foot, and Allah jalla wa ala has allowed us to take this journey by plane and then by bus. Subhana rabbil azim. It is a mercy from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that he has granted us that ease, that he has not requested from us that sacrifice. And remember, my beloved brothers and sisters, that this was what gave the companions and the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that true iman. Make sure this part of the trip is one of the most important, inshallah ta'ala. Make sure that you reflect upon your condition, your state, before you got here to make umrah to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and for Allah jalla wa ala. As Umar radiallahu anhu used to say, حَاسِبُوا أَنفُسَكُمْ قَبْلَ أَن تُحَاسِبُ. Hold yourself accountable before a day comes when Allah jalla wa ala will hold you accountable. Remember who you were before you came here, and think about who you want to become after you leave here, inshaAllah ta'ala. Remember that millions want to be right here where you are today, and Allah jalla wa ala, he chose each and every one of you individually. He chose you. You did not choose to make this trip. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala chose you to come to his house. It was not because you had the wealth. It was not because you had the time. It was not because your job gave you time off. It was because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he opened up a path for you to come to his house, to visit him, to obey him, and to worship him subhanahu wa ta'ala. So inshallah ta'ala, my beloved brothers and sisters, reflect upon those things. We're going to be stopping in about an hour and a half or so, at the only location where we can buy food, and where we're going to make Salatul Dhuhr, inshallah ta'ala. We're going to combine Dhuhr and Asr, Jam wa Qasr. We're going to combine them by shortening 2 for Dhuhr and 2 for Asr, because we may not get to the Haram until Asr time or a little bit after Asr. So we don't want to miss the Asr prayer, inshallah ta'ala. And there we request all of the people, inshallah ta'ala, we don't want to take more than 20 to 30 minutes max. So go grab some food, and come right back to the bus, inshallah ta'ala, after the salah, inshallah. Barakallahu feekum. لبيك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك لبيك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك لبيك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك لبيك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك لبيك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك لبيك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك لبيك اللهم لبيك لبيك لا شريك لك لبيك إن الحمد والنعمة لك والملك لا شريك لك. Yeah.